Did you know that 1 in 10 Europeans was conceived in an IKEA bed? Maybe. But what you probably did not know is that IKEA is the largest private forest owner in Romania, a country covered in precious woodlands that are disappearing at an alarming rate. IKEA portrays its brand as modern, sustainable, and approachable through ads like this.
Because we know that responsible forest management helps to combat climate change. We make a difference for the future of the forests and the people living around them.
And I can't deny that I have been a lifelong customer myself. But IKEA also seems to be responsible for acts like this. Critics claim that IKEA has been exploiting the forest it owns for a quick buck, hurting the environment of one of the last true European wildernesses and taking advantage of an industry that is riddled with corruption and violence. So are the critics right? Is IKEA really the bad guy? Are the organizations that make up the $18 billion world famous brand responsible for using their market power to exploit Romania's natural heritage by feeding off a broken system?
Ei au devenit direct hoți din păduri, din statutul de primar și de pădurar. Și atunci au început oamenii să fie nemulțumiți.
Faptul că în acea zonă unde mergem noi acum am fost atacat, umilit, amenințat cu moarte, îmi stârnește teamă. Și o teamă justificată.
International corporations are choosing Romania to supply wood from, knowing that the country is synonym with corruption.
We went to Romania to see for ourselves, and what we found was a logging industry out of control. The Carpathians, a mountain range stretching all the way from Czech Republic to Romania. Spruce forests as far as you can see. A source of clean air and an important carbon storage. These woods serve as a haven for plants and animals, such as wolves, lynx, and bears. But these forests are vanishing quickly. We traveled to central Romania. About a 3-hour drive from the capital Bucharest lies an area of IKEA-owned forest land. Here, we meet with Dan Turiga. Turiga is a forest ranger by training and has been working for the environmental NGO Agent Green as a forestry expert on a study looking into IKEA's forest management. And today, he is here to show us what they found out.
Aici au îndepărtat pădurea complet. O pădure care avea rol de protecție a solului și care ar fi trebuit tăiată etapizat într-o perioadă de timp de până la 30 de ani chiar și peste.
The paperwork submitted by IKEA says progressive logging was done here, meaning individual trees were taken down with regards to specification like age and height. According to Agent Green investigators, a clear cut was performed, meaning the entire forest cover was removed, and with it the habitat of different kinds of species from plants to insects and birds. Agent Green has put together this report. They say there has been systematic malpractice in forest management to the detriment of the environment, local communities, and natural protected areas.
This time we wanted to look what they are doing in their own forests. And we have taken them one by one. We have been in several forest bodies around Romania. They are quite well spread in the Carpathians. And we were very surprised about what we found.
This area is special. It is a biodiversity haven that borders a Natura 2000 area. These are areas specified by the EU to be protected because of their importance for biodiversity. All forest life here depends on these trees, which the NGO accuses IKEA of having logged in an irresponsible manner. IKEA wasn't willing to sit down with us for an interview, but they offered written answers to our questions. These answers came from Inca Investments, a franchisee within the organization's corporate structure responsible for IKEA's forests. They replied no clear-cutting was conducted in the mentioned area and all operations were in full compliance with the approved forest management plan. Adding, the trees in the above-mentioned area were removed to correct poor ecological management by a previous owner. The land needed to be prepared in order to prepare native oak stands.
Aici nu s-a realizat această regenerare pe cale naturală, însă cei care au pus în operă acest parchet au redactat documentele în perfectă concordanță cu legislația și doar aici, la fața locului, observăm discrepanțele majore între ceea ce au scris și ceea ce au aplicat.
According to IKEA's official documents and the rules in place, a reforestation of 70% should have taken place, meaning oak trees everywhere. But it just doesn't seem that way.
Uite, Max, am mers 10-15 metri de la precedentul gorun, am mai găsit încă unul, este foarte mic, acesta are cam 2 ani ca vârstă, dar faptul că noi găsim așa de răzleț nu e deloc încurajator pentru că ei n-au nicio șansă dacă nu sunt în compoziție cu alți frazai lor sau cu alte specii care să-i ajute la dezvoltarea pe viitor. Deci acesta cel mai sigur că se va pierde după încă un sezon, două de vegetație.
The wood here is not prime category wood. Dantariga counts the rings on the stump. The tree was roughly 100 years old when it was felled. On average, trees here were 120 years old, which is when their economic value begins to depreciate. Not the best quality for construction or manufacturing, so the wood will be used as firewood. In terms of biodiversity, though, the forest's importance increases with age.
They provide clean water, clean air, and store a lot of carbon. There is no other way to store more carbon than this kind of forest, which simply ceases to exist in many countries of Europe. They are home for thousands of species of flora and fauna, which have no other home than this kind of forests. There is no other place in Europe where you just walk and see several families of bears, packs of wolves, lynx, amazing birds and insects which only live in such forests. That's what it's at stake.
So everyone cares about the forests, but there's a lack of clarity which forests can be harvested and which must be protected. The EU Biodiversity Strategy for 2030 states that all remaining old growth forests in the bloc need to be strictly protected. Romania has a very broad definition of old growth forests, and NGOs, as well as other EU member states, are calling to clarify it.
We hear that there are some NGOs promoting this. All forests that are older than 100 years should be protected. This will be unacceptable in a country like Romania, because this means to protect, strictly protect, the forests that are at the age of being harvested according to the Romanian system. And there will be a lot of opposition from private forest owners, community-owned forest, and so on.
This is former State Secretary Sorin Banju, a forest expert who, until recently, worked in the Ministry of Environment. He tells us the issues surrounding logging in Romania are exaggerated and that calls by the EU Commission to find a uniform definition of old-growth forests are simply unfair to Romania.
In order to protect them all, you need to have a definition that is commonly agreed. And then you need to have criteria and indicators, and we have this experience. We are discussing with the Commission and we are telling them we have already an experience. We already have legislation, we already have criteria and indicators. Let's take this example and export it to other countries. The main problem is that these forests are not everywhere in Europe.
So logging can take its toll on the environment, in particular on biodiversity, but it also is a very valuable natural resource, especially in Romania. Over the entire EU, the gross value that the logging sector contributed to the bloc's entire economy rose from 16.7 billion euros in 2000 to 26.7 billion in 2018, roughly a 62% increase. But in Romania, it climbed from 193 million euros to 1.8 billion, meaning logging's worth to the country's economy grew by more than 900%. With the global market price soaring, wood is becoming an even more precious natural resource, and breaking laws in the pursuit of harvesting it is becoming an even greater issue. The EU has an infringement case against Romania for failing to act on illegal logging going on in protected areas, such as Natura 2000 sites. The proceedings are currently in their final step. A lot of this is happening on a small scale, but big international players are also involved in illegal practices. Austrian company Holzindustrie Schweighofer is the biggest wood processor in Romania and used to supply lumber to IKEA. The company became widely associated with corruption in 2015 after a former manager was caught on tape accepting illegal wood in negotiations. As a consequence, Schweighofer lost many clients, including IKEA. Schweighofer then rebranded to HS Timber and vowed to change, but earlier this year, a subsidiary company of HS Timber was fined for anti-competitive arrangements. In a turn of events, IKEA is now providing wood from their forest to HS Timber. This woman was one of the logging industry's biggest opponents, with parts of it resembling a downright wood mafia.
Da, din păcate există. Și există nu numai în România, există în foarte multe alte țări. La fel cum există o mafie a medicamentelor, cum există o mafie la noi chiar a manualelor, a gunoaielor. Vă spun cu certitudine pentru că am simțit-o pe pielea mea.
Doina Pana was the Minister of Environment and used her political power to take on a broken system in which auctions were rigged and quotas ignored.
Evident că pleacă de la exploatatorii de arbori. Din păcate, noi în România doar 15% exploatăm în regim de prestări servicii, în rest se licitează arborii vii, spunem pe picior. În momentul în care un agent economic a câștigat o licitație, își ia parcela să o exploateze și o săptămână, două, trei, depinde cât de mare este, exploatează și transportă. Și atunci s-a obișnuit că la fiecare transport să mai tai un arbore, doi, ilegal, evident cu complicitatea silvicilor. Deci am făcut precizarea.
For me it's kind of awkward that international corporations are choosing Romania to supply wood from, knowing that the country is synonym with corruption and that the dimension of illegal logging confirmed by the latest National Forestry Inventory, it's gigantic. The dimension of illegal logging went from 8.8 million cubic meters to 20.6 million cubic meters. That translates that for every single illegally cut tree, another one falls down illegally.
Those who refuse to be part of the system are in great danger. Over the last decade, at least 6 forest rangers were killed on the job and hundreds more hospitalized for getting in the way of illegal logging. But sometimes it is the forest rangers themselves who use violence against those shining a light on the system. This footage was filmed in October and shows environmental activist Tiberio Boșutar. He and 2 journalists were beaten and humiliated by a group of people.
Am ajuns într-o zonă unde un localnic reclama niște suspiciuni. Am chemat silvicultore să avem un dialog ca împreună să vedem dacă acele suspiciuni se confirmă sau nu. Și ne-am trezit atacați tocmai de cei angajați și plătiți să păzească pădurile. Am fost atacați de pădurar, de inginerul silvic și de o gașcă de oameni aduși de ei.
Boșutar called the authorities. Instead of being thanked, he was beaten with the butt end of an axe and urinated on, he tells us. This case made him known across the country. Though Boșutar has been active in his community for years now and dedicates all his time to the cause. Here at his house, he set up cameras outside, pointed at the main road. Trucks with wood pass through here, and Tiberio Boșutar's goal is to find those with incorrect paperwork by running their plates against a public database.
Suceava 55 CMR, văd un număr 56 CMR, văd numărul ăsta de mașină, intru în aplicație, scriu 56 CMR, mi-apare un aviz și aici pot compara cum arată camionul, cum arată încărcătura, câți metri cubi are și iar e foarte important să văd de unde anume îi emis avizul.
In the past, this was a good way to find illegal trucks, but Boșutar tells us that drivers now know about his cameras and rarely drive by his house. Even if they do, he says, illegal loggers have found other ways to trick the system. which means he has to go to the source. Mușătar takes us with him into the woods, for him quite a stressful experience.
Faptul că în acea zonă unde mergem noi acum am fost atacat, umilit, amenințat cu moarte, îmi stârnește teamă. Și o teamă justificată. Doar că mă simt obligat să continui acțiunile mele și să fac public tot ce se întâmplă acolo, pentru că altfel le-aș da hoților câștig de cauză. Ei nu trebuie să trăiască la nesfârșit cu ideea aia că nu există în România justiție.
Cu respect, bună ziua!
De la Poliția Vatrator, în George Chiariu, ce
cu respect, sunt Tiberiu Boștar și vreau să reclam niște tăieri ilegale de arbor și fur de arbor. Cioate proaspete!
After the police arrive on the scene, we continue together deep into the woods. Mușătar scouted the area already 2 days ago. He wanted us to come with him today for exposure and safety. On site, an argument erupts. The forest ranger claims he is not responsible for this area of the forest. He refuses to participate in the investigation and leaves. Mușătar believes he has other reasons. The evidence seems clear. 9 trees have gone missing. None of these stumps have official markings.
Tăiere ilegală de arbor proaspătă, în timp ce garda forestieră nici nu pe aici. Nu se tem, nu se tem, pentru că toți sunt parte la acest furt. Pădurarul nu a vrut, nu era curios să vadă. De ce? Pentru că știe. Nu poți fura aici fără acordul lui.
A serious allegation that's hard to prove.
După care facem o cercetare la fața locului.
Știți ce vreau să vă spun?
Deci după asta urmează cercetare la fața locului. Urmează să constatăm. Noi vedem că sunt niște cioate, dar noi nu pot să mai exprim.
Da.
Later, police did confirm that this area, which turns out is public property, was illegally logged and the wood from it stolen. However, cases like this rarely end up with punishment. But Mușătar is determined to carry on.
Dar toată lupta asta e justificată pentru că din punctul meu de vedere e tot ce trebuie să facem ca generațiile care vin din urmă să găsească măcar acea planetă pe care am găsit-o noi.
Doina Pana, however, had to give up on her strategy in the fight against the wood mafia. As a minister, she introduced a number of laws to break the monopoly of large companies, which cost businesses like Schweighofer hundreds of millions of euros. But she lost political backing, and in the end, she says, it almost cost her her life.
Situația mea fizică devenise dezastruoasă. Eu aveam modificări pe EKG cu iminență de infarct în permanență și mă tratam la cardiologi reputați și care nu înțelegeau de ce nu tratamentele nu își fac efectul. Și într-un final, după câteva luni de zile, între timp îmi dădusem demisia pentru că pur și simplu nu mai puteam fizic să fac față.
She tells us doctors found mercury in her blood in large quantities, a life-threatening situation that she says had to be caused by her opponents.
Și ce m-a șocat cel mai tare, vă dați seama că nu aveau acces direct la mine și atunci au trebuit să folosească oameni în care eu aveam foarte mare încredere. Asta a fost șocul cel mai mare. Dar vorbim de mafie, așa atunci nu te mai miri.
Despite the prominence of the former minister Doina Pana, years later the investigation is still dragging on and the case is still pending. Even State Secretary Soren Banju is calling for improving criminal procedures.
We really need to train and to develop skills of prosecutors and judges to have better prosecution and better results in the court, because this is what is still missing. We have special forces in police, So people specialized on forestry, and they are doing a good job. We had very good examples of prosecutors that did really good job in prosecuting criminal files. But I would say that the examples are still too few, and we need to expand them.
We're back at the IKEA plot. Forest Ranger Dan Tariga wants to show us something else. Another issue here is soil erosion. Here in the mountains, it's the roots of the trees themselves that hold the soil together and prevent landslides from happening. This is a root used to remove logs with heavy machinery. IKEA contractors use it, but IKEA says they didn't build it.
Aici au făcut un drum ilegal pe care au scos lemnul. L-au construit perpendicular pe linia pantei, ceea ce este complet incorrect. Și poți vedea cum deja s-a creat o formațiune torențială. Pe aici, în viitor, aceasta s-ar putea adânci și ar disloca aluviuni care să blocheze drumul către localitatea Târâtu.
The road, which is the only way to get to and from neighboring Târâtu village. IKEA says they've been working with communities living around their forests and they've not heard any complaints. But we have.
Și normal că sunt îngrijorat. Cu siguranță drumul o să plece acolo, pentru că ați văzut cum este. Deja el s-a lăsat spre albia pârâului. Oricum o să se rupă acolo, că o fi peste un an, doi, acolo o să plece cu siguranță. Tot dealul ăla care a fost epiras, tot o să fugă.
Another concern is the access to firewood, something we've heard many times on our trip.
Nu știu cum e la altul, dar am înțeles cât e metru aici. Adică nu-ți permiți, că dacă nu ai un salar aici, îți dai seama, trăim cu ce trebuie să trăiești aici. N-ai, nu-ți permiți să-ți cumperi lemn. Și te uiți la el, na? Te uiți la pădure.
Cât de greu ne este nou aici, că trăim în munții ăștia, cât vedem cu ochii și nu avem un braț de lemne să punem pe foc. Că vine pădurarul, te izgonește acasă, vine brigadierul, te izgonește acasă, vine tehnicianul, te izgonește, vine inginerul, te izgonește și noi trebuie să murim de frig aici în munți ăștia.
Not just there, it's becoming increasingly difficult for people to buy firewood. IKEA says in this case, they sell it to neighboring communities at market price. But we're being told the industry's demand for wood is so high, it continues to drive up the overall price and people simply cannot afford to buy. We wanted to find out about the impact of the wood industry on vulnerable communities, so we set out to the northwest of the country. Here in Cluj County, at one point or another, everyone was living off the forests. Such as Angela and Radu Mihuts. The couple moved here from the city back in the 90s. Life back then was easier. Their small gutter, a private sawmill, would be running all the time. Today, Radu Mihuts switches it on rarely and only for work around the house.
Am lucrat 20 de ani, din 98, încoace toată lumea avea de muncă, aveam 6 angajați la un moment dat, se lucra zi lumină. De când au apărut firmele astea mari și transportă la Sebeș, la Holț, se transportă tot acolo și ne-a mai dat, da, puțin, 10 metri cubi de familie pe an.
The wood they managed to get is barely enough to get them through the winter. Like most people in rural Romania, they depend on wood for heating. For the Mihuts, wood was the main source of income. Now, the couple runs a small grocery store to get by. Angela Mihuts tells us she blames international companies like HS Timber, formerly Schweighofer, for their situation.
Când a venit Schweighofer în comunitatea noastră, în satul ăsta erau 38 de gatere la 38 de familii. Oamenii aveau un trai decent. Dar în momentul când a venit ei, pădurarul nu ți-o mai da lemnție. Și puneau motivul că nu au bonuri, că nu au partidă, că... Dar ei care au vedeai mașinile zi și noapte. Pe la trei noaptea veneau la încărcat, la cinci le duceau încărcate.
Villagers have experienced the company pitting them against another. Schweighofer shared their wealth with some, creating a rift in the community.
direct hoți din păduri, din statutul de primar și de pădurar. Și atunci au început oamenii să fie nemulțumiți. I-au dat la o parte pe unii, au mai rămas numai unii, s-au făcut bisericuțile lor. Fostul primar Crainic și-au format o clică de oameni care numai pentru el lucra. În timpul ăla, pădurarii, începând din 2007, au început să-și cumpere apartamente în Cluj, în Oradea, mașini de lux, deci au înflorit, de nu știai de unde scot banii și oamenii săraci nu aveau ce să mănânce, ce să pui la copii pe masă.
For now, Angela and Rado can get their wood from a state-owned forest. It is a constant fight and very expensive. But the Mihuts are still better off than many others. This family came all the way from their village to a former logging site by horse carriage. They take the bad lumber that the industry won't accept. It is backbreaking work. But it is the only way for them to get their hands on firewood without having to break the law. So at the end of this, what did we learn about how IKEA is conducting its business in their Romanian forests? Certainly, IKEA cannot be made responsible for the state of the industry, the political environment, and the judicial system. But corruption, violence, and theft does define a large part, if not the majority, of the logging industry in Romania. But they had to know what environment they were dealing with. They have made themselves part of the game by seeking out this market, by engaging in business with other international companies that have used their market power to systematically exploit and undermine a flawed system. IKEA says, "We are committed to responsible forest management and we work daily to ensure the long-term resilience of our forests." Well, from visiting IKEA's logging sites, from talking to experts and NGOs on the matter, it does not seem like it. Take the reforestation efforts, for example. They do not reflect what IKEA claims. Perhaps IKEA did not know exactly what was going on in their forests. Perhaps they weren't watching closely enough. But now they know. IKEA categorically denies all accusations. They have cited reports to back up their claims and have shifted blame to previous owners. At this point, it's difficult for us to determine for certain IKEA's responsibility. Authorities are yet to look into it. IKEA claims no laws were broken. Let's assume that's true. Even then, environmentalists got a point that their business practices are harmful for the environment and vulnerable communities. We have reached out to IKEA both in Romania and Germany numerous times in weeks ahead of filming to sit down and talk about these very serious allegations with no success. The lack of transparency speaks for itself. The modern, trustworthy, and sustainable image the brand tries to convey does not reflect what we've experienced.